Welcome back to the BDA March Madness Finals. This is a contest for behavior analytic video content creation. Here is Jay Torres.
All life is a whole bunch of concurrent operant schedules. That was a quote from BCBA and Executive Vice President of Brett DiNovi Associates, Matt Linder, from a video where he discussed the matching law and its application to real life. In this video, I too will also be discussing real-life application of applied behavioral analysis. Only difference is, I will be discussing it on operant conditioning.
Hello, shh, keep it down. I'm supposed to be putting this laundry away before I make my video about operant conditioning and how it applies in real life. But I figure I get a jump start on it. So make sure I got all my notes here.
Oh, Jay, did you put away those clothes before you started your video? If you put them away the right way before you start your video, you can have this bag of skills I got.
For those of you that think you really know what ABA is, allow me to explain what it truly is. ABA is the practice of applying the psychological principles of learning theory in a systematic way to alter behavior in humans or animals.
BAM!
The practice of ABA is used extensively in education. It's used in healthcare. In animal training. And it's also used in business management. ABA is particularly prominent in the treatment of autism spectrum disorder, for which it is one of the only scientifically valid therapies available.
Can we play PlayStation?
First homework, then PlayStation.
All right. But because ABA has broad applications in almost any situation where a particular behavior or response needs to be taught or encouraged, ABA is constantly evolving well outside the typical range of psychological practice. Now, wherever the techniques of ABA are applied, the various techniques used remain consistently oriented toward observing and manipulating the ABCs. Now, the ABCs of ABA are a theory of behavior modification first developed by psychologist B.F. Skinner in 1938, and he called it operant conditioning. Operant conditioning is the process of learning behavioral patterns which are based on certain stimuli from the environment, such that the external stimuli leads to a certain behavior. A human being knows the kind of consequences that a particular behavior will lead to, and therefore, to either encourage or discourage that consequence, he will behave in a particular way. Operant conditioning has four subparts: positive reinforcement, negative reinforcement, positive punishment, and negative punishment. Let's see how these apply in real life. Positive reinforcement occurs when a particular behavior strengthens or increases in the hope of experiencing a positive action or behavior.
If you clean your toys up right now, I'll give you extra time on your iPad.
Negative reinforcement. In this form, a particular behavior strengthens or increases in the hope that a negative consequence can be avoided. Positive punishment. In this concept, a particular behavior pattern decreases so as to avoid dealing with something unpleasant later.
Alright, but I asked you to clean up your toys already.
No, I don't want to right now.
Alright, well, now you have another day of cleaning up your entire room.
Negative punishment. In this, a particular behavior pattern decreases so that a positive stimulus or object is not taken away or removed.
Football practice?
Football games?
Football games?
Thanks for watching what we're doing and hacking human behavior. And if you like what we're doing, go ahead and hit the thumbs up button and the subscribe button so you can get more behavior analytic content.